Good morning. It is Monday, so to get your week started right, we've got Carson Arthur.
Great. Holy cow. Good audience. I love this audience.
They're awesome. On a Monday, they make me want to come to work. So that's the lovely thing about having an audience here every day on the show. So look at our beautiful garden that you've created.
Something like that, yeah.
It's not like the gardens from before, years before,
not
where
at
you
all.
Need a huge plot of land and you need to be like toiling that soil. Now you can do it within a really tiny frame.
These are called micro gardens, and they're one of the hottest trends right now, and you're starting to see them pop up in books, this whole concept of square foot gardening.
Right.
And it's one of the biggest trends right now because homeowners can actually grow an entire crop of vegetables for a family of four in a space that's 3 feet by 3 feet. And this one's a little bigger.
This is all you need to feed
this
a family of four.
Yeah, this is the whole thing. Now, I know it looks like a window,
that's
a really sloppy window, but it doesn't have to be perfect.
Yeah.
Here's the point. This whole thing lays down on the ground.
Okay.
All right. Each one of these quadrants represents one vegetable group.
All right.
Okay. You know that this is 1 foot by 1 foot.
Uh-huh.
So when you look at your package of seeds, you're actually going to see how many seeds you can put in a space like that. Fill it up.
Okay.
Okay. But you want to put things in that repeat. Things like lettuce, spinach, mm-hmm. all of the good things that you can cut and come again, like you can keep eating all season long.
Right.
There's a one caution on this type of project.
Don't put huge vegetables in there,
well,
like pumpkins.
You're right. No vines. Vines bad.
They will be so big, the pumpkin will take over the entire thing,
it's
right?
It's true. All of your tall vegetables, though, go mm-hmm. on the north side of your garden.
Okay.
Okay, so you have to figure out what the north side is,
yeah.
first of all. But they go on the north side so they don't cast shade on the rest of the side.
Oh,
so
smart.
You can put one big tomato in here,
yeah.
no problem. Just don't let it shade everything else.
That makes sense.
So here's another version of the exact same space.
I like
now,
this one better.
This one is a little more fun.
This is pretty.
And I actually made this the other day. So what we're going to do here is we're going to keep building. These are actually layers. And each one of these tiers, you can fill and put in more vegetables.
Oh, that's
cool. So you can
cool.
keep building it up. The whole thing would be filled with soil.
Yeah.
So each one of these segments represents one section of your garden that you're going to fill with vegetables. You're going to plant it out.
Okay.
Vegetables like carrots or beets,
mm-hmm.
you want to put in one of the taller tiers because then they have more soil below to grow longer.
Right.
So things like lettuce and spinach you're going to do on the front face and the sides.
You have to do a bit of a plan then. You have to think about it a little bit. You can't just willy-nilly go throwing stuff in. Like,
exactly.
I'm going to put some peas there and some apples there. And
exactly.
You can't do that.
Anything big, green, and leafy,
yeah.
you also want to put on the north side. It requires less sunlight because those leaves are really good at creating energy from less light.
Right.
All right. So you're going to build this up. You're going to fill it with stuff.
Okay.
If you have bunnies
yeah.
or dogs
uh-huh.
or things that eat plants.
Uh-huh.
This is a great one for you because you put the plants on the front face that you know they're going to eat.
Yes.
That way they have a buffet, fine, but everything else in the rest of your garden is still safe.
That's smart.
Right? So you're going to build it up. The other thing you need to be aware of is what type of wood to use here.
Yeah, okay? What type of wood should
so,
you use?
Now, in this case, we've used something called Micropro Sienna, which is the new type of pressure treated.
Yeah.
All the big box stores are moving to this because it's safer.
Okay.
So you can actually put it near a lake. You can grow vegetables in it because it's non-toxic.
Got
Don't
it.
Use the green stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't use the iron-coated or the tar-coated railroad ties. Horrific for vegetables and fruits.
Mm.
Okay. Just don't do it. The
yeah.
other option is cedar. But if you're going to go with cedar, cedar is very expensive.
Yes, it
okay?
is.
You're going to put it in once. It's going to break down and you're not going to use it again. So you don't really want to go with cedar just because of the cost value.
Okay.
Okay. The other thing you want to remember is if you want this taller,
yeah.
Now, originally, it was supposed to be 5 feet tall, and unfortunately, I didn't...
I do remember talking
yeah.
about that in our production
yeah.
meeting.
It didn't
That's
work.
That's not 5 feet.
The reason it didn't work was because I sort of had a DIY fail.
Who
I confess,
cares?
I confess.
I love it when you tell us that, because that means you're like us.
Yeah, well, it's true.
We fail all the time. What
so
went wrong?
What I should have done was, I used 6-inch boards.
Yeah.
I was supposed to use 12-inch boards. So you can make
oh.
it significantly deeper,
okay.
right? So you could build this significantly higher.
Yeah.
5 layers. 12-inch boards, we're now at 5 feet.
Right, so and then it becomes sort of like this sculptural piece, right?
Full of vegetables and
full
all the things. Right. The other thing you want to remember is there's lots of options like vine tomatoes
yeah.
that you can actually plant on one of the top tiers that will cascade down.
That's
you
lovely.
Mentioned vines like pumpkins, zucchinis, anything like that.
Yeah.
You can actually use them on this type of planter.
Okay.
The other beautiful thing is put a piece of tarp on the bottom,
mm-hmm.
okay? And you can put this on top of a concrete pad. So if you're a condo dweller, you
right.
can actually have a garden in your condo on the path, as long as it meets permits, you make
yeah.
sure you check with your building.
Yeah.
But you can actually do this, and because it's so easy to just come apart, you can actually take it apart, put it away for the winter, bring it back out, rebuild it, and off you go.
Smart. You just have to be aware of how much light you're getting so that you can grow this stuff,
exactly.
Right?
The other thing you need to know is how much soil you're going to put into this,
yeah,
because it will hold a lot. So now, on this one, which is just a little bit bigger than 3 feet by 3 feet, you need 5 bags of topsoil.
Okay.
So for this one, you're looking at almost 25 bags of topsoil when you get it to the full height.
For this little thing.
For this little
thing. But it's because it's all going up.
It's all going up, and you want to keep piling it and keep building it. Now, at this level, obviously, it's not 25 bags.
No.
But
I like this level, too, though, Carson. It looks good. Every time you fail, you come up with something good anyways.
Well, I also thought perfect for kids.
Yeah, it's perfect for
Yay,
kids.
Yay, thanks,
you
Tracy.
Go. So are you one of those people that barbecue all winter long, or are you just bringing it out now?
I barbecue all winter long.
Yeah.
But because my clients love barbecuing, I'm always designing spaces with barbecues in them.
That's very smart. Yeah, you designed my space with a barbecue in
mind as well,
right? Absolutely,
because you wanted to take advantage of your outdoors.
Yes,
barbecues
we did.
Barbecues are a big part of that.